see you lost inside your circumstance, and I see you looking for a chance to dance, and it seems to me the world's a better place because of you. You were made to shine just like the stars above, and I know you are made for love and to be loved, and it seems to me the world's a better place because of you. We see one another and compare our lives together, thinking that the greener grass is anywhere but here. Shine, shine, set your eyes on things above now. Shine, shine, you are someone made for love now. Shine, shine, join in the applause of love and shine. So we're celebrating hand in hand, live a life worth imitating. Sing along, the world's a better place because of you. Oh, why do we see one another and compare our lives?
We had an incredible experience with President George W. Bush, also known as John Morgan. What an event, what a spirit, what a joy. I can wholeheartedly recommend his life, his ministry. We had a congregation full of people that just thoroughly enjoyed it. And he looks exactly like President Bush. I want to tell you a true story. As I was picking him up at the airport in our city, we were waiting at the baggage claim. And as we were waiting for it, people came up. I said, can I take a picture with you, Mr. President? It was remarkable. And so, you know, he looks the part. All of his mannerisms were just fantastic. And the stories were so endearing. And our people just thoroughly enjoyed it. It was a marvelous night for us, a huge success. And I'd recommend the ministry of John Morgan anytime, anywhere, to anyone.
Howdy, partner.
Well, I'm the free world leader. Freedom's rolling out to you. Oh, let's roll. Well, I'm the good news instigator. Compassionate conversator. This freedom is rocking and rolling on.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to the John Morgan Show. I'm your host, John Morgan. And I'm looking over here at my Facebook so I can get all those awesome comments in here from all you wonderful people. There's got to be a better way. Ah, it's okay. It'll start eventually, maybe. Am I live? Wait, am I live? The more things change, the more they stay the same. Oh, I love it. I still don't know because it's not showing up on my Facebook over here. You know, I think it's Donald Trump's fault. I think it's Donald J. Trump's fault why it's not showing up on my Facebook. But no matter, greetings everybody. I can't see your comments, but I know you're there, and it's going to show up here soon, and when it does, I'll be able to change that setting, and one of these days, I'm going to find out how to change that setting all the time so I don't have to do this each and every time we're together. I had the most incredible encounter today with a gentleman who performs a comedy magic show. Yes, a Christian comedy magic show, as a matter of fact. And his name is Brian Happy. That's his stage name. That's not his real name. His real name is somewhat more complicated to pronounce, and I won't even bother trying at this time. But I met him because I am going to do, as I mentioned to you earlier, a fair in near Jackson Hole, Wyoming. And I'm so excited about it coming up in just a few weeks. And part of what I'm going to be doing for the first time ever is walking around. Oh, wait. Hang on. I'm still talking to you out of a little corner. Hello, everybody. Good to see you. Oh, my goodness. I apologize for that. And I don't know how it looks to you guys, but my screen doesn't look right to me either. So I apologize if there's something wrong with the way the screen looks. You know, when amateurs try to do something in a professional manner, a lot of times there's a matter of learning as you go. Learning as you go, folks. And that's what we're doing here today. Thank you for that thumbs up. Trust me, I appreciate it right now. Still not showing up on my Facebook, but I'm showing up on your Facebook. That's what's important. So I'm there. And so a friend of mine, Greg Thompson, is the queen bee of the look-alike industry in America. He has a convention every year, although this year it's been postponed a year, called the Sunburst Celebrity Impersonators, Sunburst Convention of Celebrity Impersonators. And I lovingly call it the freak show, but it's actually my family. These are my people. These are the folks that I love to be with. And it took a while, as some of you know, for me to warm up to the whole idea of being an impersonator in the first place, because I had a negative, preconceived idea of what it would be like to be among that crowd. And you know what? Just like any crowd, there's normal people, there's regular people that have a regular job, but they look like a celebrity, and they've always had this dream of doing something, you know, on stage, like my mom always did, and they're going for it. And there's a million gazillion Elvis Presleys, and there's Marilyn Monroe's, and not that many of either of those, as you might presume. You'd think the walls would be crawling with them, but there's not. There's only a few at each of the Sunburst conventions, but there's everyone from Joe Pesci to Robert De Niro to Britney Spears to Madonna to Cher to Brad Pitt to Superman to Austin Powers. I mean, you name it. If it's a celebrity, they're likely to be. Even Betty Davis, they're likely to be represented at the convention, and it's really fun. We have 3 days, we have these different parties, we have press events, and it's our little way to be. It's like a small time celebrity, you know. And what a blast it is! And this particular friend of mine, Greg, who runs the convention, is also a performer. He performs as Austin Powers. He performs as, and he has a band that he's created that's just wonderful. They're kind of a country hick band. Greg plays the banjo, you know, and they have a stand-up bass player, and they have got the guitar, and they're called the Sweeney Family Band, and they will do strolling at the fairs, and they'll also do a stage show, and they're fantastic. And they book for more than just the fair. They book for all kinds of events. And the Sweeney Family Band, you can Google them and find them, or you can just Google Greg Thompson if you have an event and you're interested in something like that. But Greg also does a strolling act. He does a strolling act as several different characters. One of them is a dinosaur, if you can believe that. And he's got this very lifelike looking dinosaur that he wears and walks around, and it's really quite spectacular. But I was talking to him today, I was talking to Greg, and he let me know about a wearable speaker that he uses when he does walking around the fairs, and there's a microphone. He just did one, and it's really, you know, he's able to amplify his voice at a fair, which is a significant task considering all the noise around a fair. So I thought, well, I'm going to be doing some of that. Can you imagine Donald Trump and some Secret Service agents strolling through the fair, you know, posing for pictures, socially distanced, of course, with folks. And I'm going to be having the privilege of doing that. And it's fun. I love meeting new people. It's just my cup of tea, totally. So Greg told me about the device that he uses, and I got so excited about it, I went right out and bought one from my new friend Brian, who is the publisher of a magazine of Christian magicians. And they're right in the middle of their convention right now, the Fellowship of Christian Magicians, FCM. And so that's so cool. It was great meeting Brian. But this is the speaker, and I want to show it to you because it's amazing. It's really loud. It's surprisingly good fidelity and loud, packs a real punch. And yet, look how little it is. It's nothing. I mean, it's like the size of a deck of cards. It's very tiny. It's got this little belt clip. Can you see that? Belt clip right here. Speaking of clip, I'm still clipless but desperate. If anybody wants to send me a clip, I can not have this thing in my way. I broke my clip yesterday, as some of you know. And it's got an import for a microphone, but it comes with its own wireless microphone that's already synced to the device. And it's not heavy at all. It has a lithium battery in it. The old-fashioned kind would have a lead-acid battery, which was very, very heavy, and the batteries would wear out. And they've even changed the speaker magnet technology, so it's not. I mean, it's really very lightweight, but yet it packs a punch. And I just got home with it, so I haven't had time to load it up with any music. So you can load music in. You can put a flash drive in here. You can put a micro SD card. Micro SD card. And it's got a little volume control in the whole nine yards. So I'm excited about that. I was going to show you the microphone too, because the microphone is powered as well and transmits directly to the walk-around speaker. So it's going to be so fantastic. I'll be able to load up the SD card with New York soundcheck, and I'll be able to sing to people, "Stop spreading fake news." I'm leaving today. It's going to be a blast. So I'm super excited about that. And I was also super excited about meeting my new friend Brian, who is an amazing, world-class magician. And he did happen to show me a card trick. I am not going to show you the card trick, but I do have an awesome deck of cards right here that I'm going to show you. They're made of pure solid gold color. Look at this. They are Donald Trump cards, and they are, I mean, they are metallic. They are, oh, you didn't see that, did you? Oh, who wants to play 52 pickup? Whoops. But one of the things that Brian and I were talking about, I wanted to share with you today. So you know how when you shuffle a deck of cards, the order of the cards sequentially is going to be obviously different than it was before you shuffled them. So I have a question for you. Let me see if I need to get some responses from you guys. So I've got to find out. I know I'm live because I can see your beautiful hearts and stuff, but it's why isn't it showing up on my Facebook page, my own, and I'm the actual guy doing it. It's so confusing. Oh, well, we'll just have to work it out. It's crazy. If you shuffle the cards, your combination of the order of the cards will change. So here's my question. How many different combinations of cards with 52 cards, make it 54 if you add in the jokers. How many combinations are there? So I guessed to Brian. Brian asked me that question. I guessed just randomly thinking it's got to be a large, large number with 52 cards. I guessed, I don't remember the exact number, but it was somewhere in the neighborhood of 3 billion, B with a B, and then on and on, and then the rest of the number was my guess. And he said, it's actually, and he told me this number that had so many zeros after it that it's more than a Googleplex, okay? It's more than you can even imagine. In fact, he said, when you shuffle the cards, in all likelihood, you are holding a deck of cards with a combination of 52 cards or 54 cards that has actually never existed in the history of the earth. The number is so astronomically huge that every time you shuffle the cards, you are probably coming up with an order of cards that is as unique as a fingerprint. I mean, that boggled my mind. It doesn't seem possible. And yet, that's the kind of odds, that's the kind of numbers you come up with when you have 52 cards. 52 cards. Okay, so here's an afterthought to that. All right? In the Bible, okay, in the Old Testament, there are 66 books in the Bible. There's the Old Testament that was written before Christ came, and then the New Testament that began when he was born. It began with his birth and then moves on. And the life of Christ is so significant that all of human history is separated by his birth. You've got B.C., before Christ, and A.D., okay? And I don't know what the D stands for. It's some kind of Latin word. But it's crazy that all time and eternity is separated by the birth of Christ. His birth and his death and resurrection, that one single solitary life, of course, being the most important life that ever has been or ever will be in the history of the world. So, here's my thought. There are, and I haven't studied this. This isn't something, I'm no scholar, I'm no theologian, but there are over 300 prophetic utterances in the Old Testament that have to do with the coming Messiah. Over 300. There's like a ton of different authors. The span of time is just, you know, huge. From the beginning of time, Adam and Eve, the first five books of the Bible written by Moses. So Moses had some of the prophecies. David had some of the prophecies. And, you know, Jeremiah, Isaiah, all these different people who wrote in the Bible, they all uttered things that had to do with the coming Messiah. Things like they would cast lots for his clothing. I mean, that's a prophetic word. That is a prophecy about the coming Messiah, that he would be born in Bethlehem. They even picked the town he would be born in. And yet it says he would be called a Galilean, a Nazarene, one of those. And that he would be laid in a borrowed tomb, that none of his bones would be broken, that they would look on him who they pierced. Okay, his side was pierced. I mean, there's over 300 of these prophetic utterances about the Messiah. And so here's a thought. If you can take 52 cards and shuffle them one time and come up with an absolutely unique order of cards that maybe never existed in all of history, what are the odds that 300 prophecies about a coming Messiah would randomly occur in the life of one person unless it was real, unless Jesus was really the Messiah and this was all ordered by God. Because people who don't believe the Bible think that it's a bunch of fairy tales, that it was written by a bunch of men who wanted to use religion as a crutch. I mean, there's a bunch of different weird reasons why people come up for the Bible having been written, but they don't believe it. However, to me, the strongest or one of the strongest evidences of the reality of Jesus being exactly who he said he was, and he claimed to be God, he claimed to be the Messiah. Okay, no other leader in history, not Buddha, not Muhammad, not any of the other religion leaders have ever claimed to be the creator, and yet Jesus did. He claimed to be God, to be the Son of God, to have been with God at the beginning, to have formulated wisdom, to created the world. I mean, it's a huge, 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 huge claim that no one other than Christ has ever made. What are the odds that 300 different prophecies would be fulfilled to the T in the life of one man randomly? I mean, in other words, what you're saying is it was random, that it could have happened to anyone. Well, they say that the probability that all of that stuff happening in the life of one man is so random that it would be, in order to, it would be like taking silver dollars and covering the state of Texas with silver dollars, like, I don't know how high, like 6 inches high or some number, I don't remember the number, and reaching down and picking up the right coin out of all of those. I mean, it's so far beyond a trillion. It's what comes, quartillion, a five-illion, six-illion. What comes after, you know, trillion? Googleplex. You know, I don't need, it's, there's so many zeros after it that it's virtually impossible. And that's great news, because it's confirmation. It's absolutely solid scientific confirmation that Christ is who he said he is. And it's scientific, because the odds of that are so far beyond what science will use to prove a theory. Any theory will be quote-unquote proven with far less odds than that. So there you have it. I mean, isn't that cool? So from a deck of cards, I'll have to pick them all up after the show. Brian had some astounding magic tricks. Brian Happy, if you want to look him up, be happy. Get it? Be Brian dot B dot happy. That's his stage name. And he is the, why is this showing up on my, you know, I think my imperfection is your comedy. My flailing around and getting things wrong and goofing off and not having a clip and stuff like that is for your entertainment. And you know what? I'm fine with that. I'm fine with that. Because it's not about me anyway. I mean, I sadly talk way too much about myself, and I hopefully will find more things interesting to talk about than me. I wanted to leave you with a thought. If we can be as he was, generous, kind, loving, giving, then the world will believe that he sent us. No. The world will believe that the Father sent him. And so here's a song written by the great James Taylor that I'd like to share with you as just a thought and a way that we can serve humanity with simple acts of kindness. When you're down and trouble, and you need some love and care, nothing, oh, nothing is going right. Close your eyes and think of me, and soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest night. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running. Oh, yes, I will see you again. Winter green mints for us all. All you gotta do is call, and I'll be there, yes, I will. You got a friend. When the sky above you should turn dark and full of clouds, and that old north wind should begin to blow, keep your head together and call my name out loud now, and soon you'll hear me knocking upon your door. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running and running, yeah, babe, to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, hey, now all you got to do, all you gotta do is call, and I'll be there, yes I will. Hey, ain't it good to know that you got a friend when people can be so cold? They'll hurt you and desert you, well, they'll take your soul if you let them. Come on now, don't you let them. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, oh, I'll come running. Oh, yes, I will see you again. Winter, spring, summer, summer, or fall, now all you gotta do, all you gotta do is call, and I'll be there, yes I will. You got a friend. Hey baby, you got a friend. Hey mama, you got a friend. My brother, you got a friend. Thank you so much, everybody. Appreciate you tuning in. Today is show number 59. Can you believe it? Tomorrow will be 60. What in the world? God bless you. I love you. And God bless America. Oops, didn't work.
My fellow Americans, when hail rains...
That went the wrong way, sorry.
Hey, this is Al Robertson from Duck Dynasty and Duck Commander. I want to tell you about a great book called War on Fear from my good buddy, John Morgan. Of course, he looks like George W. Bush, who had the famous War on Terror, so I immediately knew, you know, there was a nice a bit of wordplay there. This book is fantastic. I think it speaks to sort of that natural fear that all of us have, whether it's public speaking or whether it's the first time you get asked to do something you've never done before, up to, you know, the fear of loss of life, of a sick person in your family, all the things that we face every single day. I recommend this highly. I promise you will be blessed when you read this book, and it's the sort of book that after you read it, you're going to want to pass that on to someone else, which to me are the best kind of books. So War on Fear, get yours as soon as you can.
My fellow Americans.
I just wanted to
show you that I actually can shuffle cards properly. See you tomorrow.
Hey, this is Al Robertson from...
I'm the free world leader.
Now I gotta pick them all up.
Freedom's rolling out to you. Oh, let's roll. Well, I'm the good news instigator, compassionate conversator. This freedom is rocking and rolling on out to you. White and blue.
Well, folks, thanks for tuning in to the John Morgan Show. I appreciate you so much for stopping by. What a hoot! It's never showed up on my Facebook. So weird. Maybe tomorrow. Where is it? Oh well. Yes, indeed. Thank you all for showing up, and at least, look at all this. Okay, you guys are very kind to me. You gave me as much love, way more love. I mean, I know you love me anyway, but lots of hearts and lots of thumbs up. I'm so grateful. Thank you, everybody. Keep that up, because it lets me know you're there. Thank you for showing up. Bye, everybody. Have a nice dinner. We'll see you tomorrow. By the way, Donald Trump is having a coronavirus update right now, so tune in and watch him. See ya.